दिस इज सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ सेल फिजियोलॉजी पावर पॉइंट प्रेजेंटेशन एंड एक्सप्लेनेशन. नाउ इन सेकंड पार्ट वी विल डिस्कस डिफरेंट ऑर्गेनल्स एंड देयर डिटेल्स रिक्वायर्ड फॉर अस. द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट द फर्स्ट ऑर्गेनल इज एंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम. When we see this endoplasmic reticulum as a whole, it is nothing but protein and lipid manufacturing factory of our cell, of our body. It elaborate fluid-filled, extensively distributed membrane structure. There are two types of endoplasmic reticulum which are continuous with each other and their relative amount varies with the function of the cell. This is endoplasmic reticulum, which is divided into two parts, smooth endoplasmic reticulum and rough endoplasmic reticulum, which extend from nucleus towards periphery. When it is a smooth endoplasmic reticulum, it is nothing but a network of tiny interconnected tubules, while rough endoplasmic reticulum, it project outwards from smooth endoplasmic reticulum as stacks of flattened sacs. The smooth endoplasmic reticulum, which has no ribosome, so not involved in protein synthesis, it acts as central packaging and discharge site for molecules which are to be transported from endoplasmic reticulum. That means formation of transport vesicles which contains new protein and lipid and is membrane bound and passes to Golgi complex. When it's the rough endoplasmic reticulum, it is useful in synthesis and modification of proteins, while smooth endoplasmic reticulum, their functions are mainly as intracellular transport, synthesis of triglyceride, synthesis of steroid hormones, detoxifications, uptake of calcium ion in skeletal muscle, and formation of peroxisomes. Well, along this, there are some additional responsibilities in different cells like steroid secreting cells, liver cells, and in muscle cells. This is the second important organelle is Golgi complex. These are nothing but the stacks of flattened curved membrane bound sacs or cisterns. These may not be physically connected with each other, but these are thin at center while dilated at periphery. The numbers may vary within the cells. When you see the functions of Golgi apparatus, main function is concentration of proteins. The secondly, synthesis of polysaccharides. Next, addition of carbohydrates in glycoproteins, cleavage of proteins, and formation of secretory vesicles. These are basic five main functions of Golgi apparatus. These secretory vesicles, they are formed from them. This contains proenzymes. When we see the mechanism of function, the transport vesicles contains cargo from smooth endoplasmic reticulum, fuses with the innermost sac of Golgi complex. The material travels through the layers of the sac to the outer sacs in the form of transport vesicles. When we see the functions of other important organelles like lysosomes, their main function is storage of hydrolytic enzymes and digestion of macromolecules. Secondly, ribosomes. Ribosomes helps in protein synthesis. Centrioles, this is required for mitotic division. After we see the microtubules and macrofilaments, the microtubules and microfilaments give structural stability and shape to the cell. And secondly, these act as transport system. When you see the structure of microtubules and microfilaments, these are of two types, centrifugal and centripetal types. We already know that nucleus, that it is a store or storehouse of genetic material. It controls all activities of the cell. When you see the lysosomes in detail, These are membrane enclosed sacs containing powerful hydrolytic enzymes. Their average numbers are about 300 per cell. The size of lysosomes in a range of 0.2 to 0.5 micrometer in diameter. These are granular when inactive. Secondly, membrane protects rest of the cell is very important. Whence this extracellular material to be taken out by lysosomes is brought into the cell by endocytosis. This endocytosis is classified into three types. They are either pinocytosis, phagocytosis, or receptor mediated endocytosis. Now, when you see this pinocytosis, it is nothing but a cell drinking activity, which is non-selective. It is a continuous process seen in all cells. Membrane deforming protein attached to membrane, formation of pouch by dipping of membrane, sealing of ends, endocytic vesicles with extracellular fluids, and vesicle is pinched by protein dynamic. This is a schematic diagram that showing pinocytosis activity. Why? Secondly, there is a receptor mediated endocytosis. It is highly selective process to import important specific large molecules. It requires energy and calcium. This is again a schematic presentation of this receptor mediated endocytosis. Next we see the phagocytosis. We are already aware regarding it or regarding the fact of phagocytosis. This is a simple presentation that is showing the process of phagocytosis. The different phases of phagocytosis are shown here. These are respectively internalization, that is called a phagosome. Second, fusion. Third, digestion. After that, absorption and formation of a residual body. And at the end, expulsion of a residual body. This is the fate of phagocytosis. Next, we see the autophagy. It is nothing but a role in regression of the organ like uterus, mammary gland, etc. Here there is observed removal of aged or damaged organelles by this process of autophagy. Then we see the next organ, that is peroxisomes. These are observed several hundreds in our cell, 1/3 to 2/3 size of lysosomes. Transport of hydrogen ions across the membrane, so acidic in pH, it is the major characteristic of peroxisomes. This is the next important structure, that is mitochondria. It has different parts, that is outer membrane, inner membrane, intermembrane space, matrix and crystal. The mitochondria may vary from 100 to thousands in single cells, energy organelles or power plant of our body. These are also known as powerhouse of our body. These extract energy from nutrient and transport it into usable form. This is the important functions of mitochondria. Number and locations in cells may vary from cell to cell. These are round shape or oval. They possess their own DNA which produces molecules required for generating enzymes. Defective DNA lead to degenerative diseases or aging. It is a double membrane which of which outer is smooth while inner is a foldable to form crystal. Now the next important part, that how the energy released from the nutrients and its storage. The energy is mainly we receive from dietary food. This energy is in form of carbon bonds. By the process of digestion, these become smaller absorbable molecules, and through cells, these go in cell through cell membrane. That means transport across cell membrane. Now, what are the uses of ATP? These are useful for synthesis of new chemical compounds for secretion and growth, secondly for membrane transport, and thirdly for mechanical work. These are the main uses of ATPs. Coming to the last part, these are centrioles. A centriole is nothing but a cylindrical shaped cell structure. The centrioles are involved in the organization of mitotic spindle and in competition with cytokines. Centrioles are very important part of centrosomes, which are involved in organizing microtubules in cytoplasm. The position of centriole determines the position of nucleus and plays a crucial role in the spatial arrangement of the cell. Now coming to the last parts, that vaults. These are three times larger than ribosomes. These are octagonal barrels with hollow interior, not seen in ordinary strip. These pass through nuclear pore, transporting messenger RNA and other material across nuclear membrane, may be responsible for multi-drug resistance in cancer cells. This is the cytosol, that is another part of the cytoplasm. It is semi-liquid surrounding organelles, highly organized gel-like mass with different composition at different sites. Cytoskeleton is dispersed throughout the cytosol. The enzymes regulating intermediary reactions, ribosomal protein synthesis, and storage of fat, glycogen, and secretory vesicles are there some functions. For instance, the second part, that is cytoskeleton, it is made up of three elements: microtubules, microfilament, and intermediate filaments. It is a complex protein network portion of cytosol which acts as the bones and muscles of the cell, giving a shape, support, and control of their movements. What is the structure of microtubules? These are largest skeletal element, slender, long, and hollow, unbranched tubes. Their functions are: this maintains asymmetric cell shape, transport of secretory vesicles and other materials in any direction by the use of motor proteins and energy, the movement of specialized cell projection such as cilia, flagellum, etc., and distribution of chromosomes during mitosis of spindles. These are major functions of microtubules. When you go to the next part, that is microfilaments, these are the smallest element of cytoskeleton. Actin is present in most of the cells. Two strands of globular actin are important part of this structure. This is the last part, that is intermediate filaments. These are tough, maintains structure integrity of the cell and resists mechanical stress. That means microfilaments in axons, keratin, skin cells are some examples. Toward the end, we see the overall functional systems of the cell. These are ingestion, digestion of foreign substances, synthesis and formation of new substructures, energy extraction, and locomotion. Toward the end of this cell physiology, we will see the intercellular communications, how this occurs. That intercellular communications may occur via three different ways or routes: paracrine, endocrine, and neurocrine. That means the transport of substances across the cell membrane. Now this is actually our second chapter, that is the transport across cell membrane. To the concluding part of this cell physiology, we learn basic three structures of cell. That means cell membrane, nucleus, and different organelles. In this chapter, toward the end, when we go with different papers, we get the first shortcut or small question, that is fluid mosaic model, which is important in theory as well as in viva voce. Along with, when we narrated different organelles along with their functions, we should underline them, which are useful either in viva voce or as a basic component of physiology. or you can write this or use in systemic physiology as per our needs. But as a medical expert, we should know these basic organelles and their basic functions required for us. When you see or end as the functions of the cell as a whole, this obtaining oxygen and nutrients from environment, performing chemical reactions, elimination of waste products, synthesis of proteins for structure and growth, controlling exchange of material, intercellular movements of molecule, sensitiveness and response to environment, and reproducing. That is very, very important. With this, we conclude this chapter, that means cell physiology.